Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to merge or combine two arrays in C++. So let's get started. So currently I'm having here a super simple code. I'm just having the header files and a mail function, and I'm also having two arrays A and B. So the first thing what you need to do is we need to find the size of both the arrays. So for that we'll be using the size of function. So it's going to be int, let al be the size of my array A, or size or length of my array A, equal to, we'll be using the size of function, so it's going to be size of, within bracket we need to pass our array name A, slash size of A of 0. I hope you know this already. This basically means that we are dividing the entire size of array A by size of A of 0, that is this first element. So this basically will give us the total length of our arrays. So I will just now copy it and paste it. So let me change it as BL, and let me give it as B over here. Yeah. So let me just now print it and check it. All right. So let me just go with cout AL. I'm saving it, running it. Yeah. So here you can see I'm getting it 3 now over here. Yeah. And another important thing that I want to tell you was, if you're initializing your array, initialize with empty values. Don't have a size. So let's suppose say that I'm putting 100 over here, is that. So if I just now save and run it, I will be getting the size of the array as 100. So here you can see I'm getting the size as 100, but I'm having only 3 elements in it. So for that purpose, basically you can just leave it empty, or you can just specify the exact number of elements, like 3 over here. So be careful there in case if you're manually initializing. So now we are done with the first step. We have found the size of both the input arrays A and B. And next thing what we need to do is we need to find the size of our combined array. So the size of our combined array will be equal to the sum of arrays A and B. So it's going to be int CL be the size of my combined array, or the array C, equal to AL plus BL. So this is obvious because this array has 3 elements. This array also has 3 elements. So our combined array is going to have 6 elements, which is basically the sum of the length of both the arrays. So that's what I've done here. And after this, we need to initialize our third array, or the combined array. So it's going to be int C of CL. Alright, because we don't know the element size at first, and we also don't know the elements. So we can't like manually assign this way. So that's the reason why we are creating this array with this particular CL, which is the sum of both the lengths. So now we are done with the first step. The second step is going to be so simple. We will be using 3 for loops. The first for loop is for storing all the elements from array A to C, and the second for loop is for storing all the elements from array B to C, and the third for loop is for just printing the contents present in our combined array C. So that's going to be the workflow now. So first let me have the first for loop. So let me just give some space. So it's going to be for int, let me just, yeah, int I equal to 0, I less than, so here we are going to copy the elements from array A. So we need a length of array A. So for that, the length is AL. So it's going to be AL and I plus plus. And we're just going to copy from A to C. So it's going to be C of I equal to A of I. That's it. Through this code, we'll be able to copy the contents from array A to C. So next thing, we need to perform the exact same thing for our array B to C. So let me just now copy the exact same thing and paste it over here. But here we need to do some modifications. The first modification is the length. So it is not AL, it is now BL over here. And here also we need to change it to B of I. But the most important change is over here. We can't give it C of I. We need to give it as C of AL plus I. That's the most important change, okay? So the reason is because once this particular for loop comes to an end, our array, our combined array CI will be like this. C of C, array C will be equal to, it will have these values 1 2 3 1 2 3. So we need to have this AL because we will be inserting this particular 10 as the third index, because this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, and the next element is going to be the third index, so 0 1 2 and 3. So for that reason we need to start this value of C of I from 3. So what this code basically does is that it will be like this. C of, because AL value is 3, it's going to be 3 plus 0 at first, because I value is initialized to 0. So at first it will begin from here. So in that case, it won't override the existing values. So that's the reason why we need to specify AL over here. So to prevent it from overwriting the existing values and continue from the length that is end of array AL. So array AL will occupy three spaces and it needs to like go to the next space. So that is the third index over here. So that's the reason why we need to add AL, not BL. We need to add the length of AL, that is the previous array. I hope that made sense. So let me just now clear it. Clear this as well. So this is now fine. And let's just copy it again and paste it again. Now we are just going to print the contents present in the combined array C. So for that, we will be using the length CL. So I will remove BL and make it CL. And it's going to be just a plain C out, C of I, and have some space. That's it. That's the code over here. Like really, really simple code. Three for loops, and this is just, we are just finding sums and initializing the combined array. I think the most tricky part is going to be this second for loop when we are like copying the contents of our array, second array, to the combined array. This is like quite tricky. If you understand the logic, this is also like a piece of cake. So simple. So let me just now run and check it. I'm executing and running it now. Yeah, so here you can see I'm getting 1, 2, 3, 10, 20, and 30, and I'm printing C of I, which means that my both the arrays A and B have now combined. And I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also run many other tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.